project log, final entry before the experiment.
Prepare to load MRD.
Close hatch.
MRD in place.
Engage sequence.
Here we go.
Hi, I'm Ben Lovett, and I composed the score for Synchronicity.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I was almost graduated out of high school before I ever picked up a guitar, and I think it was because I never knew that it was an option available to me. I grew up in the middle of nowhere in the woods of Georgia. I didn't really know anyone that played music, so it just never occurred to me that it might be okay if I did. I went to college in Athens, Georgia, and I met a group of people there who were gonna make a film. And someone introduced me to them and said, you should get this guy to do music for your movie. And I was terrified. I said, I don't know anything about doing music for a movie. And they said, well, we don't know anything about making one. And I couldn't really argue with that logic. And the guy who directed that movie is Jacob Gentry, the director of Synchronicity. I was learning how to play music from a melodic standpoint at the same time that I was equally interested in how to record music. And so my fascination with instruments was parallel to my fascination with recording techniques. And so I always felt like it sort of fused into this sort of self-taught hybrid discipline that employed both of those things in an equal measure. And so I kind of feel like I just play the studio. As a musician, I was only ever interested in how well I could play something, just to get the idea over here into another area where I was as equally interested in what I could do with it, because it was all means to an end in order to make something. When we did The Signal, suddenly I was making a movie that had three directors. And so the crash course in communication was so varied and so rich and multidimensional in that process, because I had three very talented people, all with very different ideas about how to make this movie. The film went to Sundance, became a big hit and sold, and that kind of set a lot of different careers in motion. Somewhere along the way, I got a call from Jacob. He said, hey, will you come in and take a look at the new movie I'm making? He was making a new feature that was very much informed by the aesthetics of early 80s sci-fi films. We said, let's just go for it and go full on homage into that era and have elements inspired from that era, but not just to kind of ape that stuff and act like you invented it. I think a lot of the films that most obviously influenced the look and tone of Synchronicity, films like Blade Runner, Dark City, these are all films that, like Synchronicity, are essentially a noir. Fundamentally, it's not a movie about traveling through time and space, it's a movie about people. I recorded the score in Asheville, North Carolina, which is the home of Bob Moog and Moog Music. Without their work, there would be no electronic music. There would be no Blade Runner as we know it. And it just seemed like the appropriate approach to making the score was to get their input. And I was very fortunate to be able to borrow some old things laying around, plug those in, and just have a short amount of time to record as much as I could by just playing around on some of the classic instruments like the Mini Moog and the early Taurus bass pedals. So the sound of these old synths is so ubiquitous in the canon of classic sci-fi, and all the artists who pioneered that music, there were only so many instruments even available to them at the time, and that's why it's such a narrow bandwidth of the sounds that really bring you back to that era. You know, Vangelis's workhorse was the CS80, and that thing's like you said, as big as a Volkswagen. The Mini Moog and the Prophet and the Super Jupiter. Basically, each time one of these instruments came out, it was sort of expanding space. It was creating new frontiers of what kinds of sounds you could make that were previously unheard. These analog synthesizers are as close as you get to an acoustic instrument that plugs into a wall. These are living machines in a way, and they operate a lot differently than digital synthesizers. When you start to experiment, you can kind of just stumble into some accidental magic that seems to inform elements of the film in a way that is complementary. Because the nature of analog synthesis is imperfect, something like a looping arpeggio line is gonna change subtly over time in the way that echoes things that happen in the story, very subtle differences that happen every time he's going back through the machine. It seemed like the appropriate subject matter to do a retro-inspired sounding score. What you do with that compositionally is entirely up to you now. Your perspective on those things now are going to color it in a way that's unique through your own voice. I feel like the best genre filmmaking attempts to use familiar language to tell a new story. And that's what we were trying to do with Synchronicity.